Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Monday, the Annunciation of the Lord. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Lord said, as He entered the world, Behold, I come to do Your will, O God. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who willed that your word should take on the reality of the human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant, we pray, that we who confess our Redeemer to be God and man may merit to become partakers even in his divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. First reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the nether world, or high as the sky. But Ahaz answered, I will not ask, I will not tempt the Lord. Then Isaiah said, Listen, O house of David, is it not enough for you to weary people? Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Sacrifice or oblation you wished not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Holocaust or sin offerings you sought not. Then said I, Behold, I come.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
In the written scroll it is prescribed for me, to do your will, O my God, is my delight, and your law is within my heart.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips as you, O Lord, know.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Your justice I kept not hid within my heart. Your faithfulness and your salvation I have spoken of. I have made no secret of your kindness and your truth in the vast assembly.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Second reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, it is impossible for the blood of bulls and goats to take sins away. For this reason, when Christ came into the world, he said, Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you have prepared for me. In holocausts and sin offerings you took no delight. Then I said, As is written of me in the scroll, Behold, I come to do your will, O God. First he says, Sacrifices and offerings, holocausts and sin offerings, you neither desired nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law. Then he says, Behold, I come to do your will. He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us, and we saw His glory. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. But Mary said to the angel, How can this be, since I have no relations with a man? And the angel said to her in reply, The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God. Mary said, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today we have, as I mentioned to you last week, that we will celebrate the Feast of the Incarnation this Monday because it fell on Holy Week, and then also last week was the octave of Easter. No? So it's only now that we can celebrate the Feast of the Incarnation of our Lord. So again, 3 points, just to reflect on. No? So maybe it's good to ask ourselves now, especially as it's Easter season also. How can we incarnate the Lord, the risen Lord, in our own lives? How can we bring Him to life, so to speak? How do we incarnate Him in our own lives, in our world today? And then second, to reflect on the Blessed Mother's yes, what that meant and what it did and what it means to us. Then the third and final point is that just to reflect on the total commitment of our Blessed Mother. So first about how do we incarnate Jesus in our world. Of course, again, the invitation is, as we've been mentioning over the last week of the octave of Easter, any witness now is a witness to the risen Lord. Because as we mentioned last week, as we emphasized, we live in the time of the Spirit. The church now, it lives in the time of the Spirit, and it is the Spirit of the risen Lord. So central to the proclamation of the church and our own proclamation, our own witness, is to say that He is risen, or Christ is risen. But how do we make that incarnate in the world today? Especially given the many challenges, given the many, the killings, the violence, the wars going on, how do we bring Christ into the world through our own witness, through our own participation in the mission of the church? Perhaps it will be good to reflect on that, And to bring Him into the world in very concrete ways, And within our spheres of influence, But how do we bring Him concretely? How do we incarnate Him in the world and to proclaim the good news that He is risen, So that first point to reflect on, And then the second point is to reflect on the Blessed Mother's yes, And I think when you take a look at her yes, there are two things that stand out, Number one, it is a very discerning yes. So she questioned the angel before she said yes, And I think the other side to the questioning, but I'd like to emphasize it, is, and that showed you her prudence, And remember, we've been reflecting on this in previous months, about how discernment really is at one and the same time, discerning and prudence, It is really exercising prudence even as we discern, And that was the yes of the Blessed Mother. It is very discerning, and therefore it was very prudent, And part of that prudence, you see, no, and this brings us to our third point, no, you see that in her total commitment, because all throughout her life, no, a Blessed Mother showed her discerning and prudent yes. That when everything happened, when something happened to her son and she did not understand, no, she did not give up, she did not complain, but she said yes again, no. And that yes was that when as the gospel would tell us, and she kept all these things in her heart and reflected on them. That is part of her total commitment. That all throughout her life, no, it was saying yes. It was exercising that discerning and prudent yes, no. And that was her commitment, the totality of her commitment, no. Siguro maganda na pagnilayan natin ito ngayong ano yung kapistahan ng pagsasakantawan tao ng Panginoon. Makita natin una sa lahat, paano ba natin i-gagawin din ang Panginoon na nasa present siya sa mundo natin ginagalawan? Paano natin siya bubuhayin ulit? At sabi nga, di ba, paano siya i-incarnate, no? Isa sa katawan tao natin, gagawin natin konkreto, no? Ang kanyang pananahan sa mga sitwasyon, sa mga karanasan ng ginagalawan natin na mundo, no? How do we incarnate the Lord? Paano natin siya bubuhayin sa mundong yun? Ano? Paano natin ipapakita sa mga taong nakakasalamuhan natin na ang Panginoon ay tunay na nabuhay at siya ay patuloy na nagiging kasama natin sa ating pang-araw-araw na buhay? No? Paano tayo magiging daan, ano, ng pagsasakantawan tao muli ng Panginoon sa ating mundo? No? Sa ating ginagalawang mundo. At yung pangalawang punto ng ating pagninilay ay yung pag-oo ng mahal na birhen sa kagustuhan ng Diyos. Sabi nga natin, itong oong ito ay isang mapangkilatis na pag-oo. At ito isang maingat, ano, maingat at pinag-iisipan, ito yung prudent, ano, maingat na pagtugon niya ng oo. Tinanong niya ang anghel, ano ba ang kahulugan nito? Nais niyang maunawaan, no? At dahil doon, nakatugon siya ng oo at buong-buo ang kanyang pagtatalaga ng sarili, no? Ito yung pangatlong punto. Kaya siguro maganda, no, na atin din pagnilayan ang ating pag-oo sa hinihingi sa natin ng Diyos. Ito ba ay nahahalintulad sa mahal na birhen? Na ito'y isang oo na bunga ng pangingilatis at ito'y isang oo na bunga rin na maingat, ano, na pagtitimbang, maingat na pagtanaw sa sitwasyon, no, at pagtugon natin ng oo, no. Siguro yung pangalawang punto ng pagninila. At yung pangatlo't huling punto ay kagaya ng mahal na birhen, di ba? Buong-buo ba ang ating pagtatalaga ng ating sarili? Ang ating pagtalima sa kagustuhan ng Diyos, no? Kasi makikita natin na yung mahal na birhen, di ba? Nung dito sa kwento sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, tumugon siya ng oo. Pero makikita natin sa buhay, no, ng kanyang anak, di ba nakikita natin doon may mga pagkakataon na hindi niya maunawaan ng lubos, pero patuloy siyang umuoo. Kinikilatis niya at sabi nga ng Ebanghelyo, ito ay kinupkup niya, no, sa kanyang puso at pinagnilayan niya. Yun ang aking pagtingin ko doon ay ang patuloy na pag-oo ng mahal na birhen. So today let us reflect, and especially as we ended, no, as we ended the Easter octave and as we move more into the weeks of Easter, it would be good, no, to assess our own yes to the Lord. Just like the Blessed Mother, is it a discerning yes? Is it a prudent yes? And to ask ourselves, how can that yes really incarnate Christ in our own world, especially in the particular world that we move in? Together now, let us profess our faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Through the faithful obedience of the Blessed Virgin Mary, God takes flesh among us. The mystery of the Incarnation calls us to our loving Father through the incarnate Son.
that the Church may be seen as the incarnation of the working body of Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of goodwill may learn that Christ has united himself with every person in taking our human nature, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That scientists and technologists may work with noble ideals to further human dignity and happiness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And let's also continue to pray for the good health of the Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray also for all these intentions, especially these intentions for peace. And let's also pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Be pleased, Almighty God, to accept your Church's offering, so that she who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of her only begotten Son may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this solemnity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the Virgin Mary heard with faith that Christ was to be born among men, and for men's sake, by the overshadowing of the power of the Holy Spirit. Lovingly she bore him in her immaculate womb, that the promises to the children of Israel might come about, and the hope of nations be accomplished beyond all telling. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now let us offer our prayer for the Easter season.
Risen Lord, may the joy of this season inspire us to renew our friendship with you as your companions in mission. Open our mind, heart, and spirit to the truth and grace of sacred scripture, and may the story of the journey of your disciples and the early church renew our own journey of mission in our world today. Enliven our faith that we may do all things in joyful, loving obedience and witness to the saving power of your cross and resurrection. May we be a sign of hope in our world today and bring the victory of your cross and resurrection over the evil of violence and injustice, over sin and death. Risen Lord, make our hearts burn within us that we may set our world on fire with the love and mercy of your heart. Amen.
And let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat and happy feast day and have a good day ahead and have a good week ahead. Thank you po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.